Only one of these is a crystal. This is a crystal, but this is not a crystal. What's the difference? What makes something a crystal? It's not the fact that it's shiny or that it's a particular shape or colour. To know whether something is a crystal, you have to look a bit deeper. You have to look at how it's put together. The essence of a crystal is that it has a repeating structure. There are patterns in the stuff that it's made of. For example, this is a piece of iron selenide. Not exactly impressive to look at, but it's an amazing material that has some really weird properties if you cool it down to just above absolute zero. In fact, it's a superconductor. But anyway, that's what it looks like on the outside. If you put it under a microscope, this is what it looks like. And if you could keep zooming in, you'd see that it looks something like this. Iron selenide is made of two different elements, two different types of stuff. Those are iron and selenium. In this model, the iron is brown and the selenium is green, and each little ball represents an atom. An iron atom is the smallest amount of iron you could possibly have. There are lots of patterns in this structure. If you look at it this way, you can see that on the top it goes brown, green, brown, green, and each one of those browns or greens has a column of browns or greens heading out to the left. The structure is also arranged in layers, and these patterns would continue on forever to the edge of the crystal. In fact, there is one set of atoms that repeats everywhere throughout the structure. This is known as the unit cell of the crystal, and the structure of the whole crystal can be made by repeating this unit cell in all directions. Here is the unit cell of iron selenide, marked in green. You can see it's exactly the same as the unit cell marked here in orange. The unit cell of a crystal can't just be any shape it fancies, though. It has to be a shape that will fit in with itself. It must tessellate. It must fit together without any gaps, and it must do so in three dimensions. So there are not many shapes that it's possible for a unit cell to be. So what makes a crystal a crystal? If you look at how it's made up, it's ordered and structured and made up of these tiny collections of stuff that repeat in all directions. Crystals are beautiful on the inside too.